Honey, come on over here, sugar buns. This machine just called me an asshole.
Thank you. any TV. I'm telling you right here and now, far as I says, all is holy. I'm telling you that he's the Lord Jesus.
Hey, fool, yeah!
Maybe I'll grow on you.
Look at that. There's nothing. You ever see that much nothing at 10:15 in the morning, hero?
Name's Bill.
Hi, Bill. Brett.
Sale or rent, rooms to let 50 cents, no phone, no pool, no pets, ain't got no cigarettes, but 2 hours of pushing broom buys a 8x12 4-bit room. I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road.
I don't know. Greensboro, maybe. Maybe Charlotte. Don't know. Try the radio again.
How are the lovebirds?
Heart rate is slowing down a little, I think.
That's good.
Mother's helper?
A girl hitching her way down to Florida needs some protection.
Yeah? That's what you're doing?
Yeah. That's what I was doing before every machine in the world went into maximum overdrive. You don't stick a person with a straight razor. It's more like... And I wouldn't. tell you one thing.
What's that?
You sure make love like a hero. You know what I think?
What?
I think it's a comet. You know, we've been in its tail for almost 12 hours. And if it is that comet that's making everything go crazy, then all we gotta do is stay alive for the next 7 days.
No problem. Can you sail?
A little. Hobby cats and things like that.
Good deal. You know, I used to crew the big ones. Sailboats, no motors.
No motors?
Mm-mm.
Where would we go?
I'm thinking about this place called Haven. Now, it's an island about 6 miles off the coast. And there aren't any motor vehicles allowed on the place. None whatsoever.
None?
Mm-mm.
You know, you are not only a hero, you are a genius.
Thank you. damn world's going tits up.
They can't. We made them.
We made them! Hey!
Thank you.
truck.
I hate those fucking trucks.
Keep on riding. Thank you.
Mister?
Friends, main line's open. I got the best shit on the East Coast, practically uncut. You got that fuck face?
This could be a very long day.
isn't a comet, you know. It's a broom.
What?
Broom. Imagine you're a race of aliens, right? And you're looking for a new place to live. Say you're looking for a planet, like you and I, you know, like we'd look for a new place to live, a new house or something. So here's Earth. Well, it's like this big old house. And it's kind of polluted. Dirty and smoky. Grease on the walls. Soot in the chimney. And they send in their interstellar house cleaners. Send in their broom. Sweep us all up. That's what it is, it's a broom. Using our own machines. Sweep us right off.
Yeah. going, Bill?
To the marina. We're close. About a half mile.
Human deer.
I don't want this anymore.
I got him.
Kurt!
Right there, that's the one I was thinking about.
Well, we better hurry up. Let's get in line.
We'll be right back.
have to get more whoops, not cookies.
My name is Stephen King. I've written several motion pictures, but I want to tell you about a movie called Maximum Overdrive, which is the first one I've directed.
Wow! What in the dickens is going on around here?
A lot of people have directed Stephen King novels and stories, and I finally decided if you want something done right, you ought to do it yourself.
And who was driving it?
I don't know.
Curtis! It's coming after us!
It was my first picture as a director. And you know something? I sort of enjoyed it.
What is going on?
I don't know!
I just wanted someone to do Stephen King right.
You want a war? You got one.
I just want to get the hell out of here.
So come and spend some time with me and my friends at the Dixie Boy. Spend some time in the dark.
Please don't let me in the dark.
Help me.
I'm going to scare the hell out of you. And That's a promise.
You're going to get us in an awful lot of trouble, man.
We already in trouble.
Maximum terror.
Jesus coming and he is.
Maximum king.
Maybe tomorrow will be our world again.
Dino De Laurentiis presents Stephen King's Maximum Overdrive.